హలో ఎవ్రీవన్, ఐఎమ్ యోగ్రాణి, అసిస్టెంట్ ప్రొఫెసర్, డిపార్ట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఇంగ్లీష్, కేసీఎస్ కాసినాడార్ కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్ట్స్ అండ్ సైన్స్, చెన్నై. టుడే ది వీడియో ఇస్ అబౌట్ బ్యాలెడ్, అ వెరీ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ లిటరరీ ఫామ్. వాట్ ఇస్ బ్యాలెడ్? బ్యాలెడ్ అరైజెస్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ఫోక్ లిటరేచర్. ఇట్ ఈస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ది ఓల్డెస్ట్ ఫార్మ్స్ ఇన్ ఇంగ్లీష్. Originally, it was sung from village to village. Ballad was sung to the accompaniment of a harp or fiddle by a strolling singers or bands of singers who earned a living by singing. The minstrel usually sang in the chimney corner of the farmhouse or on the village green, where a knot of eager listeners would assemble to be entertained. Example, in Walter Scott's Lay of the Last Minstrel, we see him welcomed to the castle hall. Ballad in its earliest stages. The song must have been accompanied by a crude tribal dance, as the name ballad implies, a dancing song. In the days before printing was invented, it was handed down by oral tradition. Each successive generation or locality made its own alterations to suit contemporary or local conditions. The distinguishing features of the ballad. The ballad is a short story in verse, originally intended to be sung to an audience. It developed at an early stage. Its subjects are deeds rather than thoughts. The other features of the ballad is that they are of the simplest kind, such as memorable feud, a thrilling adventure, a family disaster, love and war, and the life. The tale is usually fierce and tragic. It frequently introduces the supernatural. Characteristics of typical popular ballad. Ballad is dramatic. It is condensed. It is also impersonal. The sequence of the ballad. The narrative begins the ballad with a climactic episode. It tells the story tersely in action and dialogue. The narrative tells it without self-reference or the expression of personal attitude or feelings. For example, let us have a close look at the form of the ballad in the poem Sir Patrick Spens. The first stanza exemplifies the abrupt opening of the typical ballad and the manner of proceeding by third-person narration. It is curtly sketched setting and action. It has sharp transition and sparse dialogue. The poem goes like this. The king sits in Dumfarling town, drinking the blue-red wine. Ho! What will I get a good sailor to sail this ship of mine? Form of ballad. The poem is written in ballad measure. It has a quatrain in which the first and the third lines are 4-foot iambic, that is, a short syllable followed by a long. The second and fourth lines are 3-foot iambic. The rhyme is as follows. There lived a wife at Usher's well, a wheel, thy wife was she. She had 3 stout and stalwart sons and sent them over the sea. The tale opens abruptly without any attempt at a systematic introduction. Sometimes it begins with question and answer, which do not state who the speakers are, but make the situation quite clear, as in The Ship of the Feed. Ho, where have you been, my long-lost love, this long 7 years and mere? Ho, I'm come again to seek your love and the vows that you did swear. Mere means more in Scottish dialect. Many of the ballads are from Scotland. The ballad is impersonal in treatment, with nothing to show the writer's identity or personality. It is as though the tale narrates itself. Often, same lines are repeated from stanza to stanza as a refrain, and stock phrases are freely used. Many ballads employ set formulas. It helps the singer remember the course of the song. The stock phrases. Some of the stock phrases or conventional epithets used in ballads are merry men, milk white hand, yellow hair, red or blood red wine, gently knight, bony bride, daughter dear, pretty babe. There is no attempt in detail of time or place. The ballad belonging to a person when both could be ignored or left vague in the interest of the story. Here are a few references for further study. Thanks for listening. Thanks for your time. Thank you.